huge enthusiast of the brand, and I'm an automotive journalist, so I have to be unbiased and impartial when it comes to cars, not watches. I love this brand. I love their watches. And in 2016, I was talking to my friend, the late great chef Carl Ruiz, very famous food chef, right? And I was going to Miami, and I thought about buying myself a watch for my birthday. He goes, "You gotta go to the Miami boutique and see my friend Joe. Joe will tell you what is good, what's not good, what you gotta do." And I went and I met Joe Kirk at the boutique. He was on the shift that day, and that was a very expensive day for me. Walked out of there $9,000 poorer, and hooked on Grand Seiko and everything the brand stood for. And my friend Carl, he used to say that when Rolex messes up a watch on the production line, they take it off and fix it, put it back on the line. And when Patek messes up a watch, you know, they take it apart to nothing and put it back together, and then they sell it. And when Grand Seiko messes up a watch, the watchmaker has to commit seppuku. New York time. LA time. Hey, now, how else would you know what time it is in New York if you didn't have a watch on New York time? I can't figure out 3 hours. Screw that. Just wear two watches. It's that easy. But it also lets you really showcase your watch collection, which now I may go to four, but one angle's too. But I had just got back from Tokyo and I saw this incredible, amazing blue dial Creedor, which has this awesome. I mean, it looks like it's backlit with batteries, but it's of course not. It's the paint, the incredible work of the enamel of layering it towards the edges or close to the stack that gives it this luminescence that I've never seen a dial like it. And of course, when I saw it in the Master Boutique in Tokyo, I said, "Well, here it is. I see it's not sold. Thank goodness I'm here. I'll buy it." And they said, "Can't be done, because it's on reserve for a very famous Japanese collector." So sparks ensued. Because once I get my eye on a dial, I don't have to go crazy. So I was able to finally talk to Bryce. Thank goodness he helped me. I have it today. I've had it for like 4 days. I've walked around LA risking my life with this watch.